Isolation Station.
A very good evening to you all, and an exceptionally happy Monday. It's 7 p.m, I'm George Lawton, and over the next hour I'll be distributing plenty of phenomenally interesting chat and quaran tunes to your lovely eardrums. Apologies that Archie wasn't live from 6 p.m. Unfortunately, there were some technical difficulties, meaning that he had to cancel the show. However, he will be back tomorrow from 6 p.m. Now, you don't need me to tell you that it's National Pencil Day. I do, however, thoroughly hope that you've got your HBs at the ready. You're going to want to take some notes on the playlist of goodies I'll be furnishing you with. If you've misplaced your HBs and don't have access to a fax machine, you can also get in touch with the show on Instagram at isolation_radio or online at isolation-station.co.uk.
Hell down heaven now, living in the same town, trying to find something new. Broken picture frame, I've been frozen in, trying to find a better view. This ain't me, this ain't cool, this ain't you.
Changing, Sigma and Florence and the Machine. Now, because this radio show is run by me, the only producer is the one that lives in my head. And that means that I can play whatever tunage I want, with the only caveat being that I see a steep plunge in listener figures when S Club 7 sneaks into the playlist. However, sometimes I do like to slip in a cheeky one of my favourite tunes that you may not be familiar with, and I hope that you won't notice. Or if you do, you don't turn me over to Spotify. But YOLO. It's Monday. Here's one of my current favourite artists, Ezra Furman. Maybe you'll like it. Who knows?
I thought you'd
zero, Ezra Furman. You might recognise Ezra's tones from being a large part of the Netflix series Sex Education soundtrack. Exceptional show, by the way, and if you haven't already watched both seasons, I wouldn't even be offended if you turned me off to do so. Isolation Station. Okay, so at a time like this, I think it's fair to say that people are actually being pretty proactive in terms of sort of learning and extracurricular work. Lots are seeing this as an opportunity to get stuff done that they wouldn't otherwise have a chance to do. I think that most people are probably not too keen on the idea of turning into one of those gelatinous blobs off Monsters vs. Aliens. Anyone get that reference? No? Cool. Just me then. I've been trying to keep my mind active by trawling Twitter for radio show content each day. That's how it works, right? But don't worry, I've not been neglecting my daily body as a temple mantra, staying svelte with the Wixie every morning. Anyway, Twitter have been keeping their minds active today with the, albeit unnecessarily long, hashtag share a fact that nobody asked for. And boy oh boy did nobody ask for them. Some of my favourites. It's Piers Morgan's birthday today. You're so right, absolutely nobody needed to know that. The next one has genuinely blown my mind a little bit, probably because I was in Set 5 maths, but even still. You can swap percentage sums around to make them easier to solve. For example, 11% of 50 is the same as 50% of 11. That is genuinely mental. Numbers will always form the darkest of magics. One more. Sea otters have the densest fur of any mammal with 2.6 million hairs per square inch. I'll be honest, that fact doesn't belong on the hashtag share a fact that nobody asked for tag. And I'll tell you for why. Don't you dare assume that I'm not asking for an otter fact. I am in fact always looking for an otter fact. If somebody woke me up to tell me an otter fact, there is not a chance that I'd be angry. If they woke me up with an otter, I'd be more than happy to marry that person or otter on the spot. I genuinely like these facts so much that I'm going to intersperse a few more throughout the show. And please do let me know your best facts that nobody asked for on Instagram at isolation_radio. You're one of the vaccines. My sister's been on. She's got a couple of excellent facts, one otter related as well. And that is that otters hold hands when sleeping so they don't float away. and exceptional. And penguins give their best mate the shiniest, smoothest rock they can find. I mean, those are good facts. Izzy's been on. She says that they're enjoying the show in their household and they're having a fake pub crawl around the house for Immy's birthday. Brilliant.
When I met you in the summer, to my heartbeat sound, we fell in love as the leaves turn brown. And we could be together, baby, as long as skies are blue. You act so innocent now, but you lied so soon. When I met you in the summer,
Summer, Calvin Harris. That one was for Immy, having her 18th birthday pub crawl round the house. Happy birthday. One more cheeky fact for you. It's illegal to own only one guinea pig in Switzerland because on their own they get very lonely. Best fact ever. Well, bar any that are otter related. Hello to Kathy, first time listener in Hampshire. Thanks for tuning in.
Isolation Station.
Now then, you certainly don't need me to tell you to realise that I spend rather too much time on the old Twitter. Danger is, I just justify it to myself by saying that it's research for the show. The only issue is that in order to justify this addiction, I must include enough segments in the show that relate back to Twitter in order for my frankly outrageous number of hours that I spend to be warranted in some respect. And that's honestly not that hard. Twitter is just so weird. It's actually often difficult to put segments into the show that aren't Twitter-related. So when I was researching some facts that nobody asked for this morning, I noticed a few things that confused me. Now, number one, the word cauliflower was trending. Interesting, I thought. My mind began to spin with all the possibilities of why the word cauliflower could be trending. Perhaps a celebrity chef has published a new take on the ingredient. Perhaps somebody uploaded a selfie of themselves that looked like a cauliflower. Perhaps the UK is entering a cauliflower shortage. all very reasonable thoughts. That's what I thought. But I started to panic. The number of options was frankly overwhelming, so I clicked on the tag. I needed to find out more. And following that click, I was absolutely none the wiser. Didn't seem to be a single reason as to why the word cauliflower was trending. In fact, a Twitter user, Paul Clayton 1977, his tweet got right to the point. He said,
I'm assuming the reason cauliflower is trending in the UK is because we've all gone, why is cauliflower trending in the UK?
Excellent sleuthing skills, Paul. And for those wondering, that is absolutely how Paul Clayton 1977 sounds. I just know it. But here's the thing. These seemingly phantom trending topics happen all the time. Tom Jones was trending for a brief moment earlier. Oh God, I thought. Not Tom. Don't tell me he's got it. Anyone but Tom. Nope. Turns out just another runaway train of a tweet. Inexplicably picking up momentum. Maybe, just maybe, there's a conspiracy to be unearthed here. Is everything quite as it seems? Right, hear me out. Tom Jones sang Delilah. Delilah was produced by Peter Sullivan. In his later life, Sullivan lived in Nashville, Tennessee. Nashville was ranked as the 13th snobbiest city in the USA due to its foodie culture. Foodie website My Cactus has a blog post with the headline, Surprise, surprise, our favourite vegetable is cauliflower. I don't know about you, but I don't think that's a coincidence. Harry Styles, adore you. Don't care what anyone says, Mr. Styles' new album is exceptional. Don't get me wrong, it's not One Direction's early work exceptional, but exceptional nonetheless. Okay, another fact that nobody asked for you fine people. Here we go. There is more water in Loch Ness than all the lakes in England and Wales combined. I mean, that is unreal. I'll be honest, I genuinely didn't believe that when I first read it, but I have had the Isolation Station minions verify it and can confirm true. No wonder that sneaky little fella hasn't been found yet. Didn't have a fader up there. Smooth. Spin me round, parenthesis, like a record. Dead or alive. Remember to keep your facts that nobody asked for coming in on Instagram at isolation_radio. My sister's just texted me saying that her boyfriend's mum has texted saying that she's concerned about my obsession with otters and cauliflower. Ah, well, fair enough. as and the plastic population, the only way is up. My auntie's texted in. She's got a fact that nobody asked for. And that is that Yaz, of her plastic population fame, once played a gig in a chapel near her in Bluntisham. Who'd have thought it? Keep your weird facts coming in.
Somebody's me. I gotta be a man. There ain't no other way. 'Cause girl, you're hotter than a Southern California day. I don't wanna play no games. You don't gotta be afraid. Don't give me all that shot. No makeup on. That's my sugar.
Maroon 7. Comedy Gold. Sugar Maroon 5.
Isolation Station.
So, of course, that was terrible. That was really terrible, wasn't it? That was dreadful. Forget that happened. So, of course, we've seen a huge rise in people now working from home as lockdowns are being enforced and workplaces closed. I'm working from home, which means plentiful video conferencing and gleaming excellent insights into the personal lives of colleagues through their dodgy Live, Laugh, Love vinyls and cheap internet provider purchases. But of course, for many, it can be pretty tough to work from home. There are lots of distractions, Nintendo Switches just begging to be played with and dogs yearning to be stroked. It's tough. The most frequent advice, I think, tends to be along the lines of establish a schedule and... don't deviate from how you would usually behave at work. start work at a set time, have lunch at a set time, yeah, all that jazz. But some people have taken this idea of maintaining a regime all the way. There was a exceptional video that I saw on TikTok. I would like to issue a public statement that I do not have TikTok. Somebody republished the video onto Twitter. Do not panic. Anyway, this video showed a guy reenacting his London Underground commute in the shower, complete with opening and closing of the shower doors at each stop, flickering lights and underground announcements. By the end of the journey, the shower is full with two additional guys reading the Metro over the original fella's shoulder. It really is a masterpiece. Oscar-worthy stuff. And to be honest, at this rate, we won't have any films for the 2021 Oscars anyway. And I would certainly not be angry if this won by default.
Let's start living dangerously.
Talk to me, baby. I'm going on from this sweet, sweet baby. Been dangerously.
By the ocean, DNCE. I seem to have missed out the A there. Your facts that nobody asked for are practically flooding in at this point. And we've got one here that says, a little known fact, prior to his top-notch TV career alongside his delectable wife, Ruth Langford, Eamon worked at no less than Primark, my most favourite fashion store of all time.
Isolation Station.
So, The Guardian published an article today titled DJs on the Switch to Home Broadcasting. It's actually quite an interesting read. It starts off by talking a bit about broadcasters having to ditch the studio in favour of their bedrooms. BBC presenters are currently in the studio, however Capital and NTS have already switched. Apple Music announced yesterday that their hosts would now present their shows via FaceTime on their phone. Right, now either the hosts have a special version of FaceTime that us civilians don't have access to, or it's going to sound like a robot from the 80s is in a tunnel presenting the show. But Greg James mentioned in the article that doing the show will affect its quality. Tell that to the Isolation Station listeners, fella. Exceptional quality all day, every day. 7 till 8pm, not on Sundays. But this article there also talked about something else which I found really interesting. And that's how radio has hugely positive impacts to mental health at times like this, just through routine and familiarity. And in the article, they spoke with Sophie Scott, who is the director of the Institute of Cognitive Neuroscience at UCL. Yeah, I was offered that job too. And she said, voice familiarity is hugely important. From the moment we're born, we react differently to voices we know. We're calmed by them. It's a profound connection. A familiar voice, one that we're fond of, is both company and solace. Well, there you go, folks. From a scientist, you should listen to Isolation Station. I don't want to say it's a matter of life or death, but you should probably tell your mates to tune in just in case. Right, I've had a request for this one tonight from Rafferty. He's got a whole dance routine to Mark Ronson featuring Bruno Mars, Uptown Funk. So Rafferty, I hope you're dancing along if it's not past your bedtime.
This is that ice cold Michelle fight for that white gold. This one for them hood girls, them good girls, straight masterpieces. Stylin', wildin', living it up in the city. Got Chucks on with Saint Laurent, gotta kiss myself, I'm so pretty. I'm too hot. Call the police and the fireman, I'm too hot. Make a dragon wanna retire, man, I'm too hot. Say my name, you know who I am, I'm too hot. And my band bout that money, break it down. Girls hit you, hallelujah. Girls hit you, hallelujah. Girls hit you, hallelujah. Cause Uptown Funk don't give it to you.
Cause Uptown Funk don't give it to you.
Cause Uptown Funk. Just watch.
Just watch.
funk of the Uptown variety. Uptown funk, Mark Ronson, Bruno Mars. We've had another fact that nobody asked for come in from Rebecca. It says that in 2014, Netflix spent $0 on marketing for its DVD rental business, but over 6 million people still used it. Brilliant.
Do my makeup in somebody else's car. We order different drinks at the same bars. I know about what you did and I wanna scream the truth. She thinks you love the beach, you're such a damn liar. Well, those great whites, they have big teeth.
Well, they bite you, thought you said that you would always be in love. But you're not in love, no more. Did it frighten you, how we kissed when we danced on the light of floor? On the light of floor.
But I hear sounds in my mind. Brand new sounds in my mind. Up in a different bedroom, I whisper things, the city sings them back to you. Well, those rumors, they have big teeth.
Hope they bite you, thought you said that you would always be in love. But you're not in love, no more. Did it frighten you, how we kissed when we danced on the light up floor? On the light of floor.
But I hear sounds in my mind. Brand new sounds in my mind. But honey, I'll be seeing you.
Another fact that nobody asked for. Lord has a song called Green Light. Just so happens that this is it. Incredible.
Isolation Station.
Now then, everybody, throw your hands in the air like you just don't care, because it's Shrek's Egg time. The segment back by popular demand. Bigger, better, and Shrekier than ever before. Now, today's Shrek classic may be slightly less upbeat than you're used to, but that's fine. Shrek has bad days too. Plus, I think this might just be the most quintessentially Shrek tune of all time, by a band that are practically synonymous with the Shrek soundtrack. So, here we go. Make a cobweb candy floss, tie a snake into a balloon dog, and form a bridge across a river with a felled tree. my beloved monster, eels.
My beloved monster and me, we go everywhere together. Wearing a raincoat that has four sleeves, gets us through all kinds of weather.
Station. Oh, hey there. Welcome, I'm your friendly neighborhood good news reporter, delivering the day's jolliest piece of good news from across the globe into your eardrums and subsequently your brains. I'm really sorry. I don't know what that was. I think I've gone a bit mental today. Apologies. I would say I'll be back to normal tomorrow, but probably won't. Probably worse. Now, not only do I like to keep this segment global, but also a corona-free zone, and guess what? I've only gone and done it. You're welcome. So today's good news hails from Madagascar. Great film, great country. This story being about the country. So to celebrate its 60th birthday, the nation held its largest ever tree planting ceremony, with a million seedlings going into the ground in just a few hours after the celebratory speeches concluded. Now, the country is preparing to plant a million trees for each year of its six-decade history. That's 60 million trees, y'all! Now, the president of the country and all-round massive legend, Andre Rajoelina, said that the government has the challenge of making Madagascar a green island again. I encourage the people to protect the environment and reforest for the benefit of the future generations. Now, the campaign comes 1 year after Rajoelina's election on a campaign that promised to make Madagascar green again. Okay, that sealed the deal. This guy is my real-life hero.
Stars creak, I should sleep, it's keeping me awake.
It's the house telling you to close your eyes.
And some days I can't even trust myself.
It's killing me to see this way.
Cause though the truth may bury this, ship will carry on.
Tell her that I miss our little talks.
Soon it will be over and buried with
of life and full of love.
Some days I don't know if I am wrong or right.
Your mind is playing tricks on you, my dear.
Cause though the truth may vary, this ship will carry our bodies safe to shore. Don't listen to a word I say. The screams all sound the same. Though the truth may vary, this ship will carry our bodies safe to shore.
Little Talks of Monsters and Men, not to be confused with Of Mice and Men, that story that you probably read for your GCSEs.
Isolation Station.
Well, everybody, that was show number 10. Double digits. Not long to go until we enter the teenage years. But don't worry, we're not going to start playing any experimental lo-fi hip-hop beats just yet. I feel like we've just about got time for... one more fact that nobody has asked for, and that's that the collective noun for leopards is a leap. Huh, excellent. Sorry that Archie couldn't be with you today. He had some technical difficulties, but he'll be back tomorrow from 6 p.m. And as always, I'll be back from 7 p.m. with a very special guest, Reading football demigod and all-round top guy, Dave Kitson. Very excited for that, so please do tune in. But until tomorrow, we've got time for one more tune. We know that life can be bittersweet, but let's always try to focus on the sweet. I think you know what's coming up. It's Verve, Bittersweet Symphony. Thank you so much for tuning in again, everybody. Remember to tune in again tomorrow for very special guest Dave Kitson. Now, I don't want to say I love you all because I've got no idea who's listening, but I think it's safe to say I love most of you, probably. Just not the ones that, you know, are murderers. I do hope you can make it to the show tomorrow for show number 11, but in the meantime, be nice to people, wash your hands, and eat chocolate. About it, really. See you tomorrow.
Isolation Station.